There are 12 Microbit kits within the Inventor boxes. All of these Microbit boxes, like the plastic container, contain two sets of each Microbit. The Microbit is a microcontroller. This is a miniature computer. Inside the kit, the Microbit itself is stored inside a special static-free bag. We ask that when you pack up the kit, the Microbit is placed back inside this bag. There is also a USB cord to use when downloading the code from the Microbit to a PC. There is a battery case in which your school will need to provide two AAA batteries for remote use. Because this will be a shared item, each time the kit is packed up, please ask your students to make sure that everything on the stickers underneath the equipment is packed into the box. If there are any parts missing, please log this as an issue on the STEM T4L Library located under the tab My Learning Tools on the left-hand side of the portal homepage. The Microbit is a miniature processor, just like the processor that is in your computer. A processor takes the instructions that are provided to it and then completes the actions that are in the instructions. We use coding to provide those instructions to the Microbit. The Microbit has so many features that it's able to be just used all by itself to create so many different real-world devices, games, or use for experiments. Let's look carefully at the Microbit itself. It has LEDs all over the face. These LEDs, or light-emitting diodes, are essentially tiny lights that can be programmed to create words, symbols, graphs, and numbers. It contains three buttons, and these buttons can be used to trigger an action. One button on the back to reset the device, and the other two on the front. Now these buttons can be used independently, such as button A when pushed, or button B when pushed. But when both buttons are pressed at the same time, they provide a third option, button AB. The Microbit contains a temperature sensor inside of the processor. It's not as accurate as the thermometer, but it can provide you a very close approximation of the air temperature around the Microbit. Now, because this is electronic, please don't measure the temperature of any liquids. There is also a light sensor built into the Microbit, and this can measure light levels. The LEDs on the surface of the Microbit are used to sense the levels of light around in the environment. The Microbit also contains an inbuilt compass, and this can be used to detect the Earth's magnetic field. This will allow the Microbit to detect the direction that the Microbit is facing, just like your mobile phone does. There is also an accelerometer inside of the Microbit, and the accelerometer is a motion sensor. So this means you can measure movement. The accelerometer in your Microbit detects when you tilt it left and right, backwards and forwards, up and down. There are lots of ways that you can use the accelerometer in your projects and experiments. Now, if you've used a radio in your daily life, you'll know that a radio transmits information over a distance. The Microbit has this capability by containing an antenna hidden inside the back. The Microbit is able to be used as both a transmitter or a receiver using this antenna. To make sure that messages sent will be received by a particular Microbit If everyone in the class is going to be using the radio feature, there are channels or groups available so that the messages can be collected and received by either a specific microbit or a specific group of microbits. By containing the radio built into the microbit, this allows you to send messages, play multiplayer games, or collect data remotely by having one microbit maybe set up outside the classroom, transmitting information to another one inside of the room. Doesn't this tiny device sound amazing?
This video is part of a series of support videos all about the kit that you have borrowed. To find the other videos in this series, head to the Learning Library and visit the kit page for the equipment you've borrowed. You can also find the full list of support videos for all of our kit on the YouTube channel. You can also join us in the Yammer community. If you have any questions or you'd like to ask teachers how they've used the equipment in their classroom, then why not join us on the STEM T4L Facebook community? It's a closed group. You can ask teachers how they've used the equipment and also share the work samples that your students have created.